All right, it's the moment everybody's been waiting for. It is the Axial SCX10 Pro versus the Vanquish VRD Carbon. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're back with another video on this beautiful day. It's not really beautiful, it's pretty cold. We are suffering through the cold weather for you. I'm just kidding. It's pretty toasty in here. It's cold outside. Before we jump into this video, I just want you to know that I will be doing a video on this Iwata HPCS. I do want to get into spraying my own bodies. These are actually the first two that I've ever done. This dark color, I'm not sure I'm a huge fan of because it looks terrible in video. It looks like it is beat up and really been used. And it's really just dusty. You can see the dust really good on it. Anyway, I'm gonna be doing a video on unboxing this airbrush here, and then I'll go over the compressor that I got, what I got, why I got, and then I guess we'll learn together because I'm definitely not artistic. All right, so let's jump into this, shall we? So you pretty much know everything about the VRD Carbon here. Nothing has changed since the review video. So we're just going to set this over here to the side, and we're gonna talk about the good old SCX10 Pro. So first things first, we're just gonna go from top down. You can see that we have a Chevy, I think this is a K10 body? I'm not sure, not a huge Chevy guy myself, prefer the Ford. So as you can see, I did put a Rock Pirates roof rack on this one as well for the similarity and really the flare, I guess. So I will be putting a cantilever setup on top of this one, much like this truck. This is the second body that I've ever done, and it turned out pretty good. I'm not a huge fan of all of the stickers, which is why I bought the airbrush. So hopefully we can make some good quality paints in the future. Let's move into the truck, shall we? So you can see we have the same tires. These are actually a bit more worn in. So I'm just going to tell you straight up the facts between the two trucks. I'm not going to give excuses. I will let you make excuses in the comments below for which one you think is better and why. I am simply here to present the two different trucks and run them. With that being said, you can see that these tires are a little more scrubbed in than these tires. These are brand new. I don't have another set that are used like this. This is what we have to work with. So moving down with the truck, you can see up front here, we do have an NSDRC RS400 winch. It's got a winch mount. I'm going to put a winch in this one at some point. So I figured why not? We'll just throw the winch into this today and get going. Now, one of the other things that you do notice is that it doesn't actually have the front bumper bar anymore. I had to cut that off because it ran into the body. And then you can see on the body that I did cut a little hole for the winch itself. Other than that, the front end is pretty much stock. It does have the NSDRC RS800 V2 servo, just like the Carbon. I wanted to keep everything as similar as possible. So it does have the Holmes Hobby Revolver. It has the Mini XLX2 or the Micro XLX2. The only difference between this truck and this truck is the receiver. This is using the radio link, where this is using the Noble NB4. I did that because we're going to get an appearance from Colton. So he's going to be running one of these trucks. I'm gonna let him decide this weekend when we do the head-to-head at Lake Spillway. This is pretty much a bone stock SCX10 Pro. It is locked into underdrive in the rear, which gives it, I think, 40% overdrive in the front. And yeah, there's not much to tell. You can see this one's been used. This is the kit that I got previously. I did not actually utilize the SCX10 Pro kit that was brand new. I gave that away. It does have some wear and tear on it already. You can see here, it also has the same servo, but otherwise it's all stock. There are no weights up front on the front housing. It's just essentially a stock truck like you would get in the kit. You can see that they are very, very similar. Finally, we finally got it. I will be adding on both trucks some small pieces of Velcro for the body to attach to the sliders to make sure they stay tucked up. Other than that, the trucks, this is how they're going to run each other. I did also trim, if you see here, I trimmed the Carbon. So I did pull some of that side skirt off to go up to the sliders to match the sliders on the SCX 10 Pro. That's where we stand. Both trucks, I think, are great trucks. There are a few differences. So the first major difference is that the SCX 10 Pro is a straight axle, whereas the VRD Carbon is a portal truck. I'll let you decide which one's better. I believe the axle housings are much better on the Vanquish trucks than on the Axial trucks for a few reasons, but one of the main reasons is that if you look here, you can see that these four bolts sticking out that hold the diff cover on, these two on the bottom, they're rock magnets. Second of all, they're pointed. So they didn't use round-headed bolts, which we could put in there, but we're not going to because that's not how the kit came. The round bolts would probably help not stick on things, but those, I would say, square-headed bolts or screws or whatever you want to call them, they are a magnet to rocks and they stick on every rock and they make it almost impossible to get up and over things in the rear. May not be that hard on solid rock or slick rock or whatever you want to call it, but here in the Midwest where it's really rocky and there's a lot of really small rocks, they tend to find every rock and they tend to stick there. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to weigh the trucks and we're going to see the difference between the two. Let's jump into that. Alrighty, we're finding the scales now. We found all of the scales. All of them are good to go. Everything is zeroed out, but we're just going to go ahead and zero it out again. The passenger side of the truck is where the battery is going to go on both trucks. That will be the right side in the picture that you're going to see right over here. All right, get off the table, let it do its thing. You're seeing the same image that I'm seeing right here. All right, so it looks like the overall truck weight is right around the 89.8 ounce mark, or really the 90 ounce mark. I really feel like that's going to be very similar to the VRD Carbon. We're looking at a 57% front bias with a 43% rear bias, even with the winch, which is kind of interesting because I figured it would be right around the 60-40 mark. You can see the left side weighs a little more than the right side at 51 to 49. Once we add the battery to the right side, that should even it out at 50-50. Let's go ahead and do that. We've got two batteries here. We've got this battery that I would use in a competition. It is a 650 milliamp 4S battery. So it's a small one. And then the battery that we'll be using to do the head-to-head is I have two of these 1500 milliamp 4S batteries that we will shoot this weekend. I'm gonna weigh both of them and give you a comparison. This battery here weighs 2.6 ounces. This battery here weighs 5.9 ounces. Basically, almost double the weight of this battery is what this one is, but we're gonna test with this. Let's just go ahead and slide this on the side here where this will go, like such. We're gonna lift it up, validate that the scales are reset to zero, and we're gonna set the truck back down. We have now updated the photo that you're seeing here. Very interesting. We went from a 57-43 front to rear weight bias to a 56-44 front to rear weight bias. We're now at a 49 to 51 weight bias, meaning that the right side weighs more than the left side. We would mitigate that in a competition by using this smaller battery. For trail running, the bigger battery is fine. For competition, if you want that 50-50 weight bias, definitely gonna wanna use a smaller battery to get that weight bias on left to right. The thing that you could do is you could potentially get a bigger motor. So this Holmes Hobby Revolver 540 is actually really small and light. You could get something like a full-bodied 540, 550 motor and put it in here and make that change and potentially get some more weight up front. But what I would do personally is right now I'm running the stock hubs for the axles. I would buy some brass hubs for these axles and it would improve that weight bias. Or you could just get some tire weights, wrap the bead locker with the wheel weights and then put the tires back on. Either way, whichever way you want to do it, you probably can't go wrong there. With that heavy battery, you're looking at a total weight of 94.6 ounces versus the 90 ounces. Let's move on over and let's weigh the VRD Carbon. We've just done that in the review, but we didn't do it with the other battery. So we'll just do that real quick. This truck feels like it weighs more just picking them both up. It does feel quite a bit heavier. Actually, I don't think we have a weight without it. So let's put the body back on real quick like, and let's throw that on the scale. So immediately notice that the front end is a bit wider on the VRD Carbon than on the SCX 10 Pro. Just the truck, no battery, no winch. We are at 95.3 ounces, as you can see here. Front to rear weight bias is 58-42, which is actually better than the SCX 10 Pro. And then the driver to passenger left to right weight bias is 51-49, which is about the same as the Pro. Let's go ahead and throw the battery in there and let's see what that changes. And the front and rear weight bias didn't really change. It's still 58-42, which is interesting to me. However, the left-right bias, it did. So we went from a bias to 51% on the left to 49% on the left and 51% on the right. The overall weight difference is you're looking at 6 ounces, 94.6 ounces with the battery for the 10 Pro and about 101.3 ounces with the battery for the Carbon. So those are some interesting results. I didn't anticipate the SCX 10 Pro weighing less than the VRD Carbon. When the battery was added, the front rear bias changed on this truck where it didn't on this one. Overall, both trucks have their strengths and weaknesses. I'm not here to gab all day. I wanna get these trucks out. I wanna run some lines. And really what I want is for every one of you viewers to comment below and tell me which truck you think did best before we do the review. I will tell you the pros and cons of each and we're gonna keep it real. I know there's a lot of drama with the SCX 10 Pro when it first was released. For as much grief as I've given the SCX 10 Pro, I think it is a very good truck. Very, very excited to get these two out and run them. I'm sure you would rather see the trucks perform over what I have to say. Let's get into it.
Lighting here really sucks. You
Lucky if we get this.
Dumper there. We don't have the zip the other one's got. Hang up on the body. articulation. It does have good articulation. These tires would bite. First, like we did in the pro, steering with the camera, sorry. Look at that. Look at that. Edge balls are falling. Oh, look at it. Thank you. really extreme angle. It is fun. Bam. We got her. I'm going to try the hard line over here. Just because we couldn't get her in the... Can't get it in this one either. There must have been another rock there historically that helped. Get up over that. Thank you.
heating the old body up.
Hit it on drive and then I'm missing the camera action.
So this one ought to be able to do this fine here.
I think the Phoenix RTR did this fine. Maybe. Oh, yeah, we might. We might got her. Stuck on the bumper. We don't normally do that way anyway. Go around here like that. Go up there like that. And come back around. We're just gonna start out this way. We know this line works. Are brand new, we still got her done. Still didn't really wanna. There we go. Get her a little lower. We made it. We gotta come up over this way. That front right should start biting right about there. You can see it trying. Want to go we jumped it. That was a little tippy there. We might have to just go this way. See that remote? Man, that shit's awesome. Gotta find the right line, I suppose. Just like that. That's how you're supposed to crawl up that thing right there. On the body. Steer with the remote. I'm pretty good at that. I guess we're not gonna go up over that rock. We're going the same layer. I tried to. That's the old red cap. We're stuck. The old red cat's giving this thing a run for its money. Red cat almost did. That, ladies and gentlemen, is how it's done. All right, let's see if we can do this line here. Perfect. Ooh, maybe. Might have moved that rock. Must have absolutely moved it.
Yeah, with the VRD.
Ooh. The old spur and pinion on this guy is definitely got a lot more juice than the VRD. It does a whole lot more slowness. But look at that. Oh no! We're gonna reset that. I don't. Well, so. Choice, I suppose.
It's on the line, Choice, ladies and gentlemen.
Servo is just so powerful. Reset it and try her again. Slick. I was not expecting that.
Little deal here.
don't know that we're gonna get this one, ladies and gentlemen. Well, if I could drive. I hit the fucking rock. Get out of the way. That's the one we took with the VRD. Well, I guess we just gotta give her a little juice, huh? Did the same thing with this as we do with the car. I don't understand it because these tires are scrubbed in. They just... I don't know. I think this one's done this before. I suppose we'll see if it can do it again. No problem. Just kidding. Trim the rear bumper off of both of these. But I didn't get the left of this. Come to the left. Maybe. Off the hook. This body is getting beat up today. still gonna be sketchy because we are unloaded at the top there. I was gonna make that, but it did. Go to the right first. Get up over there like that. Fall over. It would go a little slower. It's a lot harder to control on this truck because it has more gearing.